Wednesday, September 20th, 2017. We are at the Bedford VA Medical Center, and this tape is part of the Morse Institute Library's continuing Veterans Oral History Project. My name is Maureen Sullivan. We are privileged to have with us today Joseph Barisano. Welcome, Joseph.
Hi.
May I ask when you were born?
What?
When were you born?
What about?
When were you born?
In East Boston.
What year?
1924.
And what's your birthday?
September the 11th. 9/11.
9/11, okay. And you currently are here at the Bedford VA.
Yeah.
What is your marital status?
My marital?
Yes. Are you still married? Are you widowed?
No, she passed away.
Do you have children?
Yes. I have two girls.
Okay. Do you have grandchildren?
Yes. Two grandchildren.
Do you have any great grandchildren?
One.
Okay. Joseph, tell us a bit about life in East Boston when you were a kid.
Well, it was pretty nice with all the other children playing. Yeah.
What did your father do for a living?
He was a laborer.
What kind of labor did he
He died young.
Do you have any brothers or sisters?
I had five.
What do you remember about the Great Depression?
Not really. It was a hard break.
Did you go to school?
Yes.
Did you go to high school?
Yes.
And what high school did you graduate from?
Boston English.
With what class?
I forgot.
While you were in Boston English, were you told of events happening in Europe or Asia?
It was a good school, and we were all possessed.
Were you told anything about Nazi Germany or fascist Italy? No? Now, Joseph, do you remember what you were doing the day the Japanese attacked Pearl Harbor on December 7th, 1941.
I had started a little orchestra, and we were practicing in a garage, empty garage, when someone came rushing in and told us, "The Japanese attacked us." That's how we knew, and when I went home, my stepfather said, "This is going to be a war."
Now, Joseph, you just mentioned that you had started an orchestra. What instruments did you play?
I played the drums.
Were you still in high school when Pearl Harbor was attacked?
No.
Okay, Joseph, where and when did you enter the military?
It was on I'm trying to remember. I was 18 years old.
So it would have been 1942?
Yeah.
Okay.
That's right.
And where, what branch did you enter?
The Army.
Did you sign up or did Uncle Sam go draft you?
Hey, draft for me in the Army.
Mm-hmm. Where did you take your oath?
At East Boston.
Okay, Joseph, where were you sent for basic training?
We were sent to Camp Swift, Texas.
Was this the first time you were away from home?
Yes. It's the first time away from home.
And how did you feel about it, being 18 years old and 1,000 miles away?
Well, what we missed most was the food. Always the food. My mother's cooking, you know? And the way we slept, you know, embarrassed, noisy.
Is there anything else you liked or didn't like about basic training?
Rough.
It was rough?
You know, we learned how to sleep on the ground.
And you did your drills. And you had the tough sergeants.
Yeah.
Okay.
Highly disciplined.
Highly disciplined, okay. How long were you in basic? 3 months? 6 months?
Yeah.
3? Were you given any kind of advanced training?
Where?
Were you given any kind of advanced training, like communications or rifle?
We learned about a rifle.
Mm-hmm. Do you remember what kind of rifle you were using for training?
It was a carbine. We also learned where to do our boots outdoors.
Where do you want your boots?
I said boots.
Oh, okay. In other words, the latrine. Okay. What happened after you got out of basic in Texas? Where were you sent next?
We went to Meadville, Pennsylvania. That's where it was. And then, next thing we know, they put us together to board a ship. Wow! We couldn't figure that out, you know. And we, by train, we got to the where the ship was, and we were told, you know, we're going overseas. So all of us were frightened. We thought we were going to North Africa. Finally, a crew man said, no, you're going to England. Yay! Yay! We're going to England.
Okay, Joseph, what unit were you with?
Military Devilment. I was lucky, you know why? Because I could drive. I had a license to drive. So I became a Jeep driver. To drive the officers around. I was lucky. There's not many soldiers had driver's licenses. They were from down south. Nothing.
How did you like driving the Jeep?
Quite a bit. I enjoyed it. I've been through a lot with the Jeep. Been through combat zones. I enjoyed it. You know, I drove around a captain, then a colonel, and they depended upon me. Just as a good driver. I got my driver's license when I was 16 years old. That helped.
Okay, Joseph, where in England were you stationed?
Where we were stationed? We first went to England, and we were stationed in England. And I got stationed with an English family, the McCormicks.
What part of England?
In Manchester, England. They moved us up there to get away from the bombings in and around London. But where we were up north, in Manchester, and we were militant with his English family in law.
How did you like living with the McCormicks? Did you like them?
Oh, it was wonderful. The McCormicks, we have rules not to touch any of their food, nothing in their home. And use our own toilet paper in the loo. And so, with the McCormicks, what we had as American soldiers were given different food tins, and I used to give them to the McCormicks. One of them was a can of peanuts. Oh, they went crazy. Peanuts! And so I gave them kind of thing. That's another story.
How long were you stationed in England?
I don't know, maybe 6 months, 5-6 months. And then Normandy came up.
Let's hold off on Normandy for a moment. And talk, did you do any other training besides driving the officers?
Yeah, I was driving.
Yep. But you didn't shoot anybody or drill?
What I will never forget, we were in France. The French people yelled out to us, "Merci beaucoup! Merci beaucoup! Merci beaucoup!" We were French, yeah. Thank you very much. And that was quite an experience. Très bien.
Always good words to know.
Yeah.
Well, let's get you on the way to Normandy. Did you go by ship?
Yes.
Were you told of anything about Normandy before the invasion?
What about it?
Were you told anything beforehand?
Yeah.
Just you were heading that way?
Yeah.
Okay. And did you land on Normandy at D-Day or?
No, later.
Later, okay.
Oh, weeks later.
Weeks later. And what did Normandy look like when you got there? Was it kind of cleaned up? Was it still cluttered?
No. There were some dead bodies on the shore.
But you're still drunk. Oh, what was your rank, by the way?
Yeah.
Were you a private? Corporal?
Yeah.
What was your rank?
Oh, at that time, I was a private.
All right, you're now in France. You've hit the beaches of Normandy, and you and your units are heading toward Germany. You've been getting the adulation. Merci beaucoup.
Yeah.
And tell us what the overall experience was like. Were you being shot at by the enemy?
No.
No?
No, we were lucky.
Mm-hmm.
The enemy had retreated.
So, do you remember what parts of France you were traveling? Were you going to Paris or Saint-Lô?
We're going to Paris.
And when did you arrive in Paris?
I don't remember. All I remember is the Eiffel Tower.
Okay.
And the reason why we remember that, you ready?
Go.
Here's where we urinated.
Oh, dear. Well, that's not unusual, actually.
I ran across the field.
Uh-huh.
And then the Eiffel Tower was there. And I'll never forget that. We left pools of water, and we joked about it.
Well, I have heard people say that they were actually holding it in until they got to the Rhine.
Yeah.
But okay, you've made your mark at the Eiffel Tower, and you're still heading in toward Germany, right?
Yep.
It's now around December 1944.
Yeah.
Something happened. Tell us about it. Battle of the Bulge. Were you there?
Well, we didn't know the name of it.
Uh-huh.
But we used a lot of airplanes flying overhead to look for the German airplanes. They're all over the place. And we were shooting up, and we saw one German pilot bail out of his plane, head first. Yeah. It's not, you know, the guy was fighting us. We were young soldiers.
Now, Joseph, you're in that area, and it's winter, it's snowy. Were you adequately clothed? Did you have winter clothing?
We got winter clothing.
Okay.
Yeah. We always got good clothing, you know.
Did it keep you warm?
Yeah.
Okay. What did you have to eat in the field? Were you on K rations or were you close to field kitchens?
Well, it was a mixture. Sometimes it was K rations, sometimes from a kitchen. We managed to survive with different types of meals, you know. We never complained.
Okay, Joseph. Were you driving one officer, or were you driving several officers?
Well, I was driving a couple.
You mentioned a captain. Do you remember his name?
Yeah, Captain Borum.
And what was he like?
Yeah, he was a captain from South Carolina. And he was good.
Okay. And what about the other officer?
Well, there's a few others. But Warren was the most steady, you know.
And
there's pictures of me in front of a Jeep, you know.
And Joseph, what kind of work did your Captain Boland, was it? The guy from South Carolina. Was he attached to an infantry unit, artillery unit?
Wow. Captain Borum, was he attached to an infantry unit, artillery unit?
No way. to a military government.
Okay.
We were lucky.
Mm-hmm.
Military government.
Now, Joseph, how did you keep up with news of the war? By radio? Newspaper?
No, what we heard. Everything was hearing.
Like scuttlebutt.
Yeah.
Okay. Joseph, did you ever have time to go to, say, a USO show? Or the movies?
Did you ever go to a movie, see the movies, or a USO show?
No.
No? No recreation time?
No recreation. No. No fun.
You just kept driving. Okay, Battle of the Bulge is behind you, I hope. When did you arrive in Germany?
In Germany? I was driving a Jeep with the captain, and we took over the City Hall. We became military government. We're going to run the German Sea. We would have our officers going to what they call the Red House, you know, the City Hall takeover.
Do you remember which City Hall you folks took over? Was it a specific village, town?
It was a City Hall.
Okay.
You know, town hall.
And what was the purpose of the military government? Was it to help keep the peace?
It was to keep the government running, making sure everything was running.
Mm-hmm.
You know, like the water,
mm-hmm.
the fuel.
Okay.
You know, try to keep everything as normal as possible so it makes it easy to govern the people.
Mm-hmm.
You know? And we did that.
Okay.
In one town, we took over Wuppertal. Wuppertal, Germany. We ran the town. And I fell in love with a German girl, which was forbidden. You know? Her name was Lisa Lowly. And I knew some German.
Now, Joseph, when you were in Germany, and aside from the encounter with the German girl, did you or your unit have any trouble with the locals?
No.
No?
No.
Now, do you remember where you were when the war ended in May 1945?
Yeah. We was in Wuppertal, and we heard that the Japanese had surrendered too.
Well, that's a few months down the line.
Yeah. Oh, we were happy. So that meant we could go home. Since we were always afraid we would end up going to Japan, you know. You never knew what was going to happen. You never knew.
So you were in Germany when the Japanese surrendered?
Yeah.
And you were
we celebrated.
Mm, I'm sure you did.
You didn't have to worry about going to Japan.
Now, Joseph, excuse me. How long did it take you to head back home to the United States? Did you have enough points?
Yeah.
Okay, and when did you get back to Boston?
Oh, I forgot, but it was exciting to get back.
Did you go back in 1945, 1946?
It was 45.
45, okay.
Yeah, I believe it was 1945. Yeah. My mother was happy.
I'm sure she was.
All mothers are happy when they have sons who go overseas. They come home.
Okay. Were you still a private?
No.
No?
I was a corporal.
Ah, you're moving up in the world.
I was a military government, a corporal. Check five.
And you were discharged out of Boston? Okay. Did you receive any medals or commendations? I understand you had battle stars.
Well, I got 4 battle stars.
And where did you get those? Did you get one for like Normandy and the Bulge?
Yeah, all different areas, you know, they just gave them to you.
Okay, and did you all get any other medals? Like
no.
Defense service?
No.
Okay. Did you join any veterans organizations? Like the VFW?
Can't remember.
Okay. Did you take advantage of the GI Bill?
Yes.
All right.
We all did.
And what did you use yours for? Did you go to school?
Well, I bought clothes.
You bought clothes, okay. Did you go to school on the GI Bill?
Yeah.
Where did you go to school?
Well, school I went to originally was Burnett College. You
and
could not get into any school at the end of World War II.
Mm-hmm.
All the GIs were lined up as they were trying to get in. Nazism was packed, BU was packed. The only one was a business school, Burnett College. But all the GIs, SGIs, were hit every school. Oh, name the school.
And what did you major in at Burnett?
I majored, believe it or not, accounting. Boring!
Well, it's a living, right? So what did you do after you got out of college?
I started the business.
What did you do after you got out of college? What did you do?
Well, I don't work, believe it or not, as an accountant in a small business. But then it grew. I grew. I started my own business in advertising. It was quite successful,
And when did you move to Nahant?
I forgot.
You moved to Nahant in 1958?
Yeah.
So you were in Boston, of course, right after World War II. Were you approached to join the Army when Korea became more than a headline?
My wife called everything.
Uh-huh.
that we, she worked some radio, she worked some television. She was well known.
What was your wife's name?
Well, the real, she went under the name of Marilyn.
Marilyn?
Yeah.
Okay.
There's a picture of her up there.
Oh, okay.
It's a blow job.
So you started your own advertising company.
Yeah.
And you moved to Nahant in 1958.
In Boston.
Okay. Now, Joseph, did either of you, did children or grandchildren, did they join the military?
No.
And I understand you were also, you also wrote for newspapers?
What?
You wrote for newspapers.
Yes, I wrote for the Boston Herald. I became a columnist, writing for different publications. I became well known as Ray Barron, my professional name. Ray Barron. And
why did you use another name, Ray Barron?
Well, that goes back to when I was a young kid. We formed an orchestra, and we didn't know what to name the orchestra. So one of the guys' name was Ray, and they knew my name was Barisano. We could use Ray Barry. So some said, no, make it the Baron. Originally, yeah, 1-0, you know, but, you know, I changed it for the sake of music.
And did you still play music from time to time? Did you still play the drums?
No.
No?
I play the keyboard. There's a picture of me playing the keyboard. I like the keyboard.
Mm-hmm. What I was getting to earlier, that you were in Boston during post-war. The Mass Pike was being built, 128 was being built. The city was just beginning to transform. Can you give us an impression of what that time was like?
Yeah.
What was it like in Boston?
After the war.
After the war.
It was great. It's a good city. And I'll never forget, I participated in the dedication of the JFK building, you know, in Boston.
Yep.
And I wrote for the governor. A little speech. What is America? America is a nation of nations. Right down the road was the North Germany, all Italian. Right up the road was Chinatown, all Chinese. We were quite a city, you know. Science and the Chinese. And the Irish were across during Dorchester, around that area. Still Irish and South Boston.
Joseph, did you ever meet James Michael Curley?
What?
Did you ever meet James Michael Curley?
No, I never met him.
Okay. Kevin White?
Kevin White.
Yeah.
You knew Kevin White? You met Mayor Kevin White. Who did you know that worked for him?
Yeah, Kevin White.
Kevin.
I knew a lot of people because of my business, you know, and they knew, you know, I could handle them, give them ideas. I said, all right, can't complain. Mm-hmm. Yes.
Okay, and you were still working in Boston during the Vietnam War.
Yeah.
Okay, so any thoughts on that?
I don't remember what we did. Oh, the war.
All right, Joseph. Is there anything else, any other stories from your service that you'd like to say? From World War II.
Any stories that you would like to talk about from World War II?
The other thing I would talk about is how getting into Germany, capturing the cities and towns, and then, of course, meet the Fräulein!
You missed the Fräuleins.
Yeah. It was good.
Joseph, how important was it for you to serve in the military?
Very important. I was proud to be in the service, proud to drive a Jeep, you know, proud to take care of the officers, you know, keep driving, getting them around. They depended upon me. You know, I learned how to drive at the age of 16. I was ahead of everyone, you know.
Joseph, is there anything else you'd like to say before we wrap up this interview?
Yeah.
Anything you want to say?
Yeah.
How about the being here at Bedford? Are you getting good care here?
You're getting good care here? Are you getting good care here?
Great. These people are great. They know how to take care of people.
Okay.
They're very good.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Joseph Bolzano, we thank you so much for taking part in the Natick Veterans Oral History Project.
Thank you.